The results are in, my friends. NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite has identified over 850 candidate exoplanets, or planets outside our solar system, some of which have the potential to support life. TESS, that hardworking gal, has been on this exoplanet hunting mission for over a year. And not only has this satellite exceeded the wildest dreams of the many scientists who use it to find exoplanets, but it's also gathered unprecedented data on other astrophysical phenomena like exocomets and supernovae. TESS uses four large, specially designed cameras that are able to scan the sky for stars outside our solar system. The cameras view overlapping sectors of the sky for 27 days at a time, waiting to see the brightness from a star blip in a certain way, an event called a transit. This indicates that something has passed in front of the star, likely something that's orbiting it, like a planet. This method is called transit photometry, giving TESS the first part of its name. And TESS triple checks her work, too. That same object must pass by the same star, causing the same blip at least three times before being considered a candidate exoplanet. Once potential exoplanets are identified, TESS then notifies astronomers on the ground to take a closer look with their telescopes to confirm. TESS has already helped identify at least 28 confirmed new exoplanets, with more being confirmed every day. Scientists are looking at these planets to see if any of them could potentially host alien life. But that's not even the only reason we're interested in exoplanets. Some of them are what scientists are calling missing link planets. These are somewhere in between smaller, rocky planets like our Earth and larger gaseous planets like Neptune. We don't have any of these in-betweener planets in our solar system, so these missing links will be really exciting to study because they'll help us understand how these kinds of planets form alongside rockier, more Earth-like worlds and how these solar systems evolve in the first place. TESS has already pointed us to several solar systems that look really promising, including three planets of particular interest that orbit a relatively quiet star that's relatively close to us. When I say quiet, I don't mean that it's not blasting heavy death metal. I mean that this star doesn't flare very often, which makes it and the planets that move around it easier to study. And when I say close, it is 73 light years away, which sounds like quite a ways, but is actually considered a close neighbor of ours. The star in question is a red dwarf star called TESS Object of Interest 270, or TOI 270 for short. It's got at least three planets orbiting it, and these are the ones that we're looking at closely, TOI 270 B, C, and D. They're all varying distances from the star, with estimated temperatures ranging from a toasty 250 degrees Celsius to a nice and cool 66 degrees. One of the larger, gassier planets is identified as a mini Neptune, one of these missing link planets. It was initially thought to be in the habitable zone of its star, meaning it could have liquid oceans and host life. But as scientists have looked at it more closely, they now think that TOI 270D's atmosphere is too thick, making the planet a greenhouse that's probably far too hot to host life. So that's a bummer. But researchers still want to probe the compositions and characteristics of the planets orbiting TOI 270. Plus, they think there may be other planets in this system, so we're not giving up. TOI 270 is also just one of many systems that TESS has pointed us toward. And while looking for star planet systems like these, TESS was also able to observe other exciting things outside our solar system, like exocomets. And because TESS looks at one particular patch of the sky for so long, it can also observe stellar events, like the beginnings of supernovae. Again, this means that TESS can then tell ground telescopes to take a closer look, which researchers hope will help us better understand the origins of astronomical explosions of all different kinds. And get this, scientists can then use those observations to calculate how fast the universe is expanding. Hopefully, we'll be able to get even closer looks at all the stuff that TESS has scouted out for us when the James Webb Space Telescope eventually launches. The JWST could even take measurements of the compositions of these exciting planets and their atmospheres, telling us even more about whether these exoplanets could support life. Thanks for the recon mission, TESS. We can't wait to see what else you point out for us. If you want to see just how close we are to launching the JWST, make sure to check out this video here and subscribe to Seeker for all your planetary discovery news. If you have other planet questions for us, leave them down in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching.